What's going on, YouTube? Long time no video. I thought that I would make a 2017 update on the Accord. So, this, if you don't watch my channel, this is my 2001 Honda Accord EX Coupe 5-speed. I've owned it for officially a year, just the other day. It turned over a year. I bought it late October 2016, and I'm going to talk about what I've done to the car, positive and negative, and what I plan to do with it maybe later on. So let's get started. So let's start on the exterior. See, right here in the front, I upgraded to gold emblem here in the front. It's not quite an exact fit, but I personally think it looks decent. I bought it at the junkyard, I think for like a dollar or some stupid amount. Anyway, it was off of a Honda Passport. That's what it was. Yeah, walk around. I still haven't gotten fog lights because they're freaking expensive. Anyway, I still have the same wheels. I haven't dipped them or anything, but people are always like, oh, go get wheels for this thing. It looks so good. I'm like, I know, but that's money, and the tires are still really good. These are the tires that came on the car. They're wearing kind of weird. I noticed that, but you know what? What are you going to do? Walk around the side. Got a nice little scratch here, which... I just bought a bumper, so I'm gonna fix that. My cord batch fell off. Right here, I have obtained a couple scratches. Whatever. Right here, I've gotten an OEM spoiler. This is not the original spoiler. The original Accord one comes with a little Accord emblem down there, but this one is just eBay. It's kind of flimsy, but you know what? It looks good. It does the job. In my opinion, it looks so much better than without. This is an OEM exhaust tip. I got it at the junkyard for, I think, $5. It's a lot cheaper than if you were to get it at H&A for $25, which, that's a win for me. I did cancel out this third brake light to go on the spoiler. Walk around the side. Oh, stay in there. I got it around Christmas time, because I got it as a present. Sunroof visor. It is WeatherTech, and it's actually for an 08-010 Accord, but it fits perfectly fine here. I need to push this down a little more because I took it off during the summer for just to see if it was better, but I just like how it looks, even though it's a little bit noisy. Huh? CG. Twin. Alright, on the inside, nothing's really changed. Right here, I got a leather insert from another Accord. I'm planning to make this wood grain, you know. So a lot of people don't like that, but I personally do, and I'm gonna get the leather door panels. I did just shampoo the seats. They're very clean right now. Other than that, very clean. I upgraded to Acura TL leather wrapped steering wheel. It's a little bit beat up, but I'm okay with it, and it smelled like cigarettes when I bought it, but it's perfectly fine now. Right here, I got a fog light switch for when I do get fog lights. I just put it in for fun. Floor mats. I am planning on getting a new floor mat for this drive set because it's got a hole in it. It came like that when I bought it. Headrests and everything. Let me hop in here. I upgraded to a wood grain right here. It was just black before. I like it. Still have the stock shifter. I actually broke the original stock shifter. One of the pieces under here broke off, and so it wasn't holding this part in, so I just got a new one from the junkyard. I'm doing a lot of junkyard shopping just for fun. Still the same climate control. I looked into getting auto climate control, but there's a lot more electronics that I want to deal with. Nothing really has changed in the interior other than those two things that I mentioned in the panel there that I changed out. Same stereo. I've got the kicker with the Kenwood unit. Pop the trunk. Or pop the hood. My bad. And I'm going to talk about what I've mechanically done. Right under the hood, here's 2.3 F-series motor, whatever, F23. So mechanically, I haven't really done much with this car at all. I did upgrade to HIDs. There's where the ballast is. I did a horrible job mounting app, but I'm gonna change it in the future. That was just like pushed in there. But the biggest thing that I did was I blew out the clutch a little while ago. It was supposedly new when I bought it, but it started slipping, and I didn't do anything stupid like try to do burnouts. I did not. So I don't know how it started to die, but I did all the labor myself. It only cost me about $100, which which is a total win for me. I used somebody's facilities to change it over. I did not do it at my house. I used a lift and I used full Snap-on toolkit, so that made it so much easier. But it took me about 24 hours to do it because I've never really done anything major. But you can't tell that the clutch will change. I did the valve cover gasket here. I think it was around May because I got my license around that time as well. So I got it done right before I started dailying this car, which I don't know if it, it used to have a problem where there was oil in the spark plugs, but not anymore, the spark plug wells. So that's completely perfect. It still burns a tiny bit of oil, but I got, there was a ton of oil deposits down there, but I got that all degreased mostly. I still need to get it completely clean. And there's a little deposit here just from me putting the oil cap there and filling it up. It still takes about a quart every 1,000 miles, so a couple quarts. I plan to change out this air box and put in a cold air because it sounds so good. One of my friends got one. He has an a V6, but it sounds so phenomenal. And I popped this off one day just to see what it sounded like, and it sounded amazing. So that's what I decided. I'd showcase the HIDs. They're 8,000 Kelvin HIDs. 8,000K. I really like them. It's just the low beam. I did not change the high beam. It looks kind of wacky, but you know what? What are you going to do? I like it. And I actually learned this with the Accord. It has auto turn off headlights if you leave it on, shut the door, and leave. I thought that was... One last side note, I did get... I don't know if anyone noticed, but I had a really awful key fob. But I got a new shell for this one. This is the original one, but it's some cheap Chinese thing, and it's like wearing apart. So I want to try and find out. Plans for the future for this car. So soon, I would like to get new front and rear bumpers, or get them repainted. Somebody hit me in a parking lot. I was really, really upset about that. And they didn't say anything, unfortunately. So you can see there's a mark there, and then there's just a bunch of paint taken off. And as you can see, it's like, just from 150,000 miles, it's super beat, and there's just crow's feet all over. This is not fixable with paint fixing. I took it to a detailing guy, one of my friends who does professional detailing, and he said it was no good. I need to repaint it. I would like to get fog lights. I might not get the factory ones. I might just take this little grill out, which it's just removable. You don't have to cut anything. It's really nice. Here's a close-up on the rear bumper. I screwed up and handlebars from a bike. I was hauling a bike in my car, and I hit a little planter box in a parking lot. It was kind of stupid. Interior, I do plan to get some leather seats. I was looking into just changing the material, and it actually might be a lot easier than I expected, because this part just comes off. I don't know about the top, though. I did take one apart in the junkyard to see what it was like, but I haven't found any good leather seats that are nice, because the problem is with the front airbags, you gotta make sure they actually have the airbag. So I thought I'm gonna get the passenger seat and the rear seat and just throw them in the junkyard and then just get the material, because the power seat is also hard too, because these have the V6 or any of them that really have leather have the full power seat with the power recline and whatnot. And so it's hard to switch it over. And I don't wanna do any major wiring. I want it to all stay factory. And I might also install some heated seats. But if I do that, I would like to get the little piece from here, from a Canadian model, have it shipped or something, because they have the power heated seat option, which is right here. You can just get a switch from an Odyssey or an Acura TL because they're the same. So I might do that too. But one thing for sure is I am going to re-dye the cowl and repaint the wiper arms. That's a must because I think it just bruised it up a lot. I'm going to be polishing the paint very soon. I just bought a buffer, and I just need to get cutting pads and whatnot. And I'm going to redo the glass, re-polish it, because it's got water spots all over. I'm planning on also getting LED turn signals for these. I've seen people retrofit like LEDs, like the 0607 Accords have the coupes and the, or it's, yeah, it's all of them, actually. They have the triangular, but this is different, obviously. So I might just get the bulb, or I might get that. But I think that would be amazing to have, like, what Dodge does it a lot. They have the strips around here, whatnot. Same with the headlights. I'm going to get a housing that has LED, because my housings that I have right now, walk over here and take a look, are a little bit faded. I treat them every time I wash the car, but it just goes back so quick, and it just isn't perfectly clear. And so I think it would just make it look so much better if I did that.
The last things last, I'm gonna start it up for you guys. So currently, I just rolled over 159,204. So 159,000. I bought it with 151.5 on it, so let's start it up. Still running like a top, runs amazing, super quiet still. Runs and drives amazing, just because of the new clutch, it's just awesome. The clutch is a lot lighter than the old one, that's for sure. Anyway, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed, and just remember, like the video, subscribe, whatever. And you know, if you want to see more stuff with the other cars, the Civics, the Odyssey, maybe the Saturn, just look out for that, because I'm going to be doing this more soon now that I can drive places. Anyway, thanks for watching.